Now, Scotland Yard is facing serious questions over parliamentary security tonight after environmental activists superglued themselves hand in hand around the Speaker's chair. This was Extinction Rebellion. The protesters had accessed the House of Commons chamber by booking onto a public tour. Outside, demonstrators locked their necks to gates and unfurled banners calling for urgent action to tackle climate change. Eight campaigners were arrested by police and taken into custody. Mike, this was a peaceful process, protest, but it could be, we always say it could be very different. Probably not over here, actually. It's never very different over here. Well, if it was in the United States.
Yeah, but what if they weren't actually just Extinction Rebellion terrorists, which is what they now are? They're now actually invading the parliament, right? So that should be, should it not, some kind of act of terrorism. You know, because I'm pretty sure if anybody else went in there and started unfurling banners and saying we're going to take the place over, they're using terror tactics, right, to take over the national seat of government. Hang on a minute, there are people there who have got protection from bodyguards, right?
Yeah,
they may not have been there at the moment, but this is a very.
But
they might have been there. You don't know if they're there or not. Some MPs are in the Houses of Parliament because that's where their only offices in London. The point is, it's a place that should be secure. It's not a place that anybody should be able to wander in on just because they bought a ticket for a tour. I mean, it doesn't exactly bode well.
Calling them
it?
Terrorists is a bit extreme.
I don't think it is. I think they are.
It's a form of terror.
I would rather it's a form of protest. I'd rather they were going into the House of Commons and doing this than doing it on petrol stations or doing it on the roads and blocking me from getting to work. Yeah. I'm happy they're doing it at the House of Commons.
I thought we were all in this together and you all had to do your own thing. You just care about your own car now.
Yes.
Okay.
So
there's a right to protest. There's a right to peaceful protest.
Yes.
Absolutely. I don't think Extinction Rebellion are going right about this the right way, but they do have a point. I also think that likening this to terrorism devalues actual terrorism because, you know, gluing yourself to Parliament and unfurling a banner is not the same as blowing yourself
up. Well, let's see if they tried it inside the White House and see what would happen then, because they'd get shot.
It's hardly the Capitol riots, is it?
I'm not saying it's the Capitol riots, but this is meant to be the most secure place in Britain, right?
I understand
It's where the laws are made, it's where the Prime Minister sits and works.
Of course.
Should not be accessible to anyone who wants to wander in.
No, but they were on a public tour. You know, they've obviously booked it. We've sat on this panel so many times and covered Extinction Rebellion, Insulate Britain, Just Stop Oil, and said they're just being disruptive to members of the public. It's about why don't they go to Parliament and do something? And they actually
went to Parliament Square.
And Parliament's in recess. Yeah. But, Mike, if news channels and papers reported on protests that take place outside Parliament, then they wouldn't have to go to these
measures. But they do, though. They get pretty good coverage.
Yeah,
this is the other
thing
that annoys me, that they're always saying, oh, we've got to raise awareness of climate change. That's all we ever talk about is climate change. And who's on the tour tomorrow? Hezbollah. They're going to bring him in.
You know what?
Come and have a look around the speaker's chair. Come on, what are you doing there? You've left something behind. No problem.
There won't be any public tours now, will there?
That'll be it. It's escalated quickly, hasn't it?
What I thought was interesting about it is they had banners up saying, we demand a people's parliament. It's like, this is a people's parliament.
You're actually in it.
It was voted for. It's people in there voted for by. That is a parliament.
No,
Did they not know where they were?
A citizens' assembly, which is an amazing idea.
It's a ridiculous idea. It's a great way to run a sixth form.
No, but there's only advisory, right? Because politicians that care about the most popular, you know, the most popular policies, not the policies that actually are going to benefit us in the long term and benefit the environment.
There's nothing popular about Extinction Rebellion, though. There's nothing, nobody likes
them. Policies are, if we'd insulated Britain, we wouldn't be going through the heat crisis that we're
going
through.
When you say insulate Britain, we'll, like, put a big woolen bandage around Britain.
Yeah, a bit of cotton wool.
Wrap us all in cotton wool. That's what the snowflakes want.